greetings and welcome home. I am honored that you have joined me for this momentous occasion as we approach the bicentennial, the founding of Norwich University. As you know, back in my day, we called it the American Literary, Scientific, and Military Academy. But a change in name is but one of many changes that has transpired over the decades. These include 3 locations, 23 presidents, the birth of the Reserve Officers Training Corps, the introduction of civilian students, the inclusion of women in the Corps, changes in the curricula, and the addition of online courses. Suffice it to say that the only constant throughout nearly 2 centuries of existence has been change. And for good reason. An institution that cannot adapt to the times will not thrive. Which is why I am so proud of my successors. Visionary leaders such as General Ernie Harmon and Dr. Loring Hart, General Russ Todd, and Admiral Richard Schneider, men who possessed the courage and conviction to make sweeping changes during their tenure. Please join me as I take a nostalgic walk down memory lane, and together we can reminisce over some highlights from some 200 years of transformation. In 1819, I chose my hometown of Norwich, Vermont, as the site for my groundbreaking American Literary, Scientific, and Military Academy. I am proud to say it was the first institution in the United States where military training was combined with a practical education, including courses in agriculture, modern languages, mathematics, and civil engineering. I called this innovation the American System of Education. I founded my academy so as to prepare citizen soldiers to protect and defend the Republic in times of peace and in times of war, whether in uniform or as civilians. And I am pleased that Norwich has continued this mission while keeping current with the ever-evolving trends of higher education. Today's faculty have access to the latest teaching technologies available, and today's students are engaged in methods of learning I never dreamed possible back in 1819. But in addition to being the first private military academy in the United States, Norwich University can lay claim to a number of pioneering innovations. We were the first private institution to offer instruction in civil engineering. Since then, Norwich graduates have been at the forefront of every important advancement in the field, to include the design and construction of railroads, bridges, dams, highways, and other water systems. Current Norwich graduates are fulfilling our nation's demand not only for engineers, but also for experts in the fields of computer engineering, cybersecurity, and architecture. Meanwhile, our popular criminal justice and nursing programs continue to turn out graduates ready to step into professional careers at home and abroad. Over time, our dining facilities have evolved to keep pace with the appetites of a growing student population. In the 1940s, the mess hall was located in a Quonset hut. It was later replaced by White Hall, where cadets ate at long rows of tables and were served by student waiters. Many of you here have fond memories of marching down to mess in formation and listening to the announcements from the crow's nest. Today's students dine cafeteria style in the bright and modern WISE Campus Center and get their campus updates on an online portal. Athletic facilities have also kept pace with the times. Our earliest hockey teams played outdoors on a flooded Sabine field. In 1956, Moses Taylor Riding Hall was converted into one of the few indoor ice rinks in the state of Vermont.
Cadet center in front, they score!
Today's Kreitzberg Arena, built in 1998, is one of the finest collegiate hockey rinks in New England and the proud home of our perennial powerhouse men's and women's hockey teams. No stroll through history would be complete without mention of the regimental band, the oldest collegiate band in the nation. Our band has had the honor of performing in inaugural parades for seven presidents and in concerts throughout New England. They have even been invited to perform in New York City's St. Patrick's Day Parade and the annual Patriots' Day Parade in Lexington, Massachusetts. Since its earliest days, Norwich University has promoted military training as an integral component of the education of the citizen soldier. This time-honored tradition of physical fitness and readiness to serve one's country continues today in both the Corps of Cadets as well as the Reserve Officers Training Corps. When I founded the Academy in 1819, there were no women in the Corps of Cadets because at that time, few women enrolled in higher education, and especially not at a military school. That changed in 1974, when the first female cadets joined the regiment. In 1975, Diane Halliday was the first female cadet to graduate and commission in the United States Air Force. In fact, in 1997, there have been four female cadet colonels, along with many female battalion commanders. Along with the inclusion of women in the Corps, one of the most important transformations Norwich has undergone in the last 200 years has been the addition of civilian students. This change came about in 1972, coinciding with the merger with Vermont College. Norwich graduates, uniformed and non-uniformed personnel, serve in leadership roles in the public, private, and nonprofit sectors. But with all this talk about transformation, I am very happy to see that one thing hasn't changed. Whenever and wherever Norwich alumni gather, friendships are rekindled, stories are told and retold, and the years melt away. The abundant pride that members of the Norwich family feel when they return to the Hill warms my bones and strengthens my spirit. Your loyalty to Norwich has helped this institution survive the dynamics of higher education, the unsteady national economy, and ever-changing demographics. Your commitment to our values and our mission, and your willingness to stand by us through challenging times is what keeps us strong. In 1819, I envisaged a Norwich that bears little resemblance to what is here now, but I am deeply honored that so many of the values I instilled in the cadets of yesteryear are still being cultivated in the students of today. As we prepare to embark upon our third century of service, I know you will remain faithful to the past while facing the future with courage and conviction. But now I have one, before I take my leave, I have one important duty to fulfill. President Schneider, I am passing the torch to you to light the way to the future of Norwich. May it provide a clear vision to guide and strengthen the university to meet the challenges of the next 200 years.
Captain Partridge, I will try. Great job. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, sir. Well, farewell. And until we meet again, Norwich forever.
Bye, Captain.